We have managed to get children to school, but the quality of education is still a cause of concern.
Finance Minister Arun Jaitley found the situation serious enough to expand the budgetary allocation to education by 7% in budget 2018 from the previous year's figures to 85,010 crore rupees. Specifically, the outlay for school education was hiked to 50,000 crore rupees. Almost every state government has been taking similar steps. After all, education is on the concurrent list, meaning it is the responsibility of both the union government and the state government. But a glance at various state budgets shows that education, especially primary and secondary, is not necessarily at the top of every state's to-do list. Let's take six states as examples: Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra, Bihar, West Bengal, UP, and Chhattisgarh. An analysis of the annual budgets of these six states over a five-year period by the Center for Budget and Governance Accountability and child-centric NGO CRI shows that Tamil Nadu, Chhattisgarh, and UP have increased allocation to education as a portion of their budgets. Maharashtra has kept outlay relatively steady. But for Bihar and West Bengal, the outlay for education as a percentage of the entire state budget has actually gone down.
There are no multiple returns in that sense. And also, why people who can afford education from private sources, why should state provide for them from the public province? So these have been two very critical questions which have resulted funding to a school education getting diminished.
Ultimately, resources are shared among the students, and so the number of students matters. Going by child population, Tamil Nadu has registered the highest per capita spending in FY18 with a unit cost of 23,464 rupees per child. Maharashtra, among the states in question, comes a close second, spending 21,100 rupees per child. Bihar's spending is the lowest at 7,920 rupees per head among the six states studied.
National average में हम कुछ कम हो सकते हैं क्योंकि बिहार तो जानते हैं वो एक गरीब राज्य है पिछड़ा राज्य है और हम अपने मेहनत से आगे बढ़ने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं.
But state spending is just one problem amongst many. CPGA says there's an acute shortage of qualified teaching staff at government schools. India's elementary schools alone need at least 5 lakh more teachers to be able to impart basic standards of education consistently. And 14% of government-run secondary schools do not have the prescribed minimum of 6 teachers.
This year we have done redeployment. Okay. And today we have surplus teacher rather than, you know, deficit.
But in stark contrast, Bihar and UP together have over 4.2 lakh teaching vacancies at the elementary school level alone. Poor infrastructure at government schools is the third major problem. From basic facilities like benches and toilets to outdated teaching instruments and apparatus, teachers and even government officials say a lot more is required to first get students to attend and then to ensure a decent quality of education. Insufficient funding, shortage of trained teachers, and poor infrastructure are just three of the many problems that the Indian education system is facing today. The degree of these problems is different in each state, and so is the manner in which they deal with it. In the next part of our series, Get Schooled, we take a look at Tamil Nadu and Maharashtra, two of the best performing states.